So among the collections here at the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts, we have depictions of Christ that literally go across the millennia, from Europe, from Africa, from Asia, and of course from the Americas. Often you see Jesus in particular depicted in a Last Supper type setting or in a crucifix setting. And they span the ages, but also in terms of style. In the contemporary world, you see less and less, which makes Stanley Rayfield's painting even more magnificent in its own right.
My name is Stanley Rayfield. I'm 32 years old. I've been painting for over a decade, and I found that God led me down a path to become a fine artist. My primary mediums that I use in my work are pencil and oil paint. The painting of Stephen was done in oil paint. I used cold wax medium. I also added notebook paper to add additional texture. The yellow notebook paper with the lines, to be specific. I met Stephen while I was at art school at VCU. We were both artists together. We bonded over life and relationships. I was not trying to make a political or radical racial statement. I was just trying to show a depiction of Christ that I felt was underrepresented. My intention for creating it at the time was, well, maybe my image will show up on Google one day as a positive reference to do something good with it. So why did I pick Stephen, somebody who's not a devout believer? I don't initiate the people that I choose in my artwork. A lot of times they're shown to me and I reach out. And what I've seen is that every person that I allow to be part of the process, that I felt they were the person, I found it to be the perfect person for that project. And when I look at the success of this painting and the fruit that it's bore, then that tells me, biblically speaking, that God says that it's good.
The piece came about from a friendship that Stanley and I have had for years. I learned that he was on his journey to becoming a Christian man. He had an idea of using me as the muse for this painting. We have different faiths and different backgrounds, but I thought that it was an honor. So I posed for the piece. We took photographs. He then did a few sketches and showed me the sketches after they were developed a little bit more. And I was just kind of taken aback by his talent. Stanley and I have collaborated on two pieces from the same photo shoot that he created a drawing from. You know, I've been contacted by friends I have in Brazil, talking about how it's been picked up by media companies and used by politicians. I've seen it used in articles where you have, you know, archbishops in different countries talking about, you know, how the depiction of Christ shouldn't always be a white man. I do think it's interesting that so many people are offended by it and that there's so much controversy, because there doesn't seem to be the same amount of controversy when he's falsely depicted as white. Imagery is important. The things that are happening in Richmond right now, the Confederate monuments, the protests, you see messages going up all over the city, and people understand that narratives and history are shaped by our depictions and our historians' depictions of important figures, and Jesus being one of the most, if not the most important figure in our history, it's just really important for other people to be able to see themselves in this type of figure.
Hey, this is Steve. Leave a message. I'll get back to you.
Hey, what's up, Steve? I heard you're back in Richmond.
Yo, this is crazy. Like, your timing is perfect, man. Look,
you should come to the studio when you get a chance, man. I've been working on some things. And, yeah, man, we need to catch up. It's been a minute. So, yeah, just hit me back and let me know. Peace.
Yo, what up, Stan?
What up, Steve?
What's going on?
I'm good, man. Pull up a chair.
Yo, I wanted to tell you, I got around to seeing that piece. I actually saw it in the museum this time.
Oh, okay, yeah. You were telling me about that.
Yeah, I'm so used to just seeing it on my iPhone screen, but to be able to see it actually in that context was pretty wild, man.
Were there other people there that saw it?
There was a few. I actually saw this lady and her husband, and they were talking. I kind of overheard them when they had left the gallery. I don't know, she looked like she was appalled or something. She was like, Jesus wasn't black, he was this and that. I mean, do you get that a lot?
Like, I know when I created it, it was just simple because I was doing research one day about Jesus depicted in different cultures. Yeah. When I looked up the black versions, most of them were just white versions that they made the skin dark,
on
Photoshop.
Right.
And I was like, oh, come on, you gotta do it justice.
I kind of have a feeling that, you know, you wanted to do another one. That would be a little bit weird if you paint me again and then.
Well, I do want to do another piece. I'm not sure what it's going to be yet, but you know, if you're open to it, I'd like to. You know, how do you feel about that?
I'm open to the idea of it if it's the appropriate time, just because of what's going on. There's a lot of people in the streets who are angry, and there's a lot of doubt. And I'm just kind of curious if like. Your attention should go more towards like activism because you have, you know, you're very gifted. So I don't know if, you know, if people see it as like thoughts and prayers or something like that, you know?
Yeah. An artist I was inspired by, Henry O. Tanner, he did a lot of pieces about his faith, about his spirituality, and he was like one of the first African-American painters to get some serious recognition. But at the time that he was painting, he could not get credit in America because of racism. What I'm inspired about his pieces in particular are just how he's able to depict faith scenes without being so overt with it. He's able to just go into these scenes from the Bible, but you wouldn't know it's a scene from the Bible until you read the title.
Now, the next piece, do you want to have some of that ambiguity, or are you trying to do something that is very much, you know, crown of thorns? Maybe it's not just a picture of me as Christ. Is there a way to like incorporate like stuff that's going on in the world or make some type of comment? I mean, I know you're the artist, but
I got you, man.
You know.
I mean, yeah, I would want, you know, that's good. It'd be great to find a way to tie it in, you know? Because there's a lot going on. There's a lot of eyes awakening to a lot of things, and it's a perfect time to create something hopeful. In the painting, I have Jesus depicted with the crown of thorns. I wanted to get a version of him that's very noble, it's very hopeful, almost expecting. Prior to his crucifixion, he was praying in the Garden of Gethsemane, and he had a moment with God where he was reflecting on this great task ahead of him.
Art shapes history. I think especially with us being in Richmond right now and seeing what's going on with the monuments, people are getting really kind of like tired of seeing these things that are oppressive and actually were put there to be oppressive, then they're kind of feeling like the images that, you know, the city has chosen to put up on a pedestal, literally, it affects people and how they think about things.
I knew that this vision had a field in it. Wasn't sure where I'd find it, but I saw one. And when I went to it, they had cut all the grass. And it
I thank you, Lord, how you woke us up today, God.
I just bless you, Lord. Without you, there'd be no me, God. And so I just ask you that as I work on this painting, as I work on this project, I want you to get the glory. I want you to touch men's hearts. I want you to inspire people, plant seeds of hope. So even with this photo shoot, God, guide me, guide my direction. I thank you, Lord, for the wisdom and the power and the strength. In Jesus' name, amen. The Bible talks about how when Jesus walked the earth, the people that should have known him didn't recognize him. They thought he would come some other way. They thought he'd be a different type of Messiah. So when he came, a lot of people didn't believe it was him. And I think that the notion of Jesus being a color, a complexion that other people are not comfortable with really should make you look in the mirror and ask yourself, well, if he is that a problem? If you say you believe in him, if you say you love him, if you go to heaven and you find out that he's black, is that an issue? Right now, I believe a lot of us are coming to the realization that we all have a lot more in common than we have different. So I just believe that being here with this painting is an opportunity to check people's hearts. America wasn't founded on all positive things. If the Confederacy had won the war, who's to say that my dad, he could have been a slave, I could be a slave. Who's to know for certain? But that dark legacy is something to consider when you think about what your art is used for. As an artist, we have a lot of power. And when that beauty is used for the right things, you can do amazing things.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.